Hello, everyone, and welcome to our virtual New Year's Eve celebration here at the Museum of Discovery. We are so excited, even though we can't have you here in person, that we can be with you virtually to celebrate this fantastic event. We're going to have a lot of fun as we count down to 12 o'clock p.m. My name is Sean. I am your host with the most.
The most what?
Hair, of course. And this is the foreman of fun, Miss Jackie.
Hello.
Now, Jackie, today we are going to have a lot of different things for you. There will be animals and dancing and crafts and all kinds of fun things leading up to some explosions and then our big finale as we ring in the new year.
I like explosions.
I do too. And I don't want anybody to miss any of this. We have to make sure that we stay on track and make sure that we keep our eye on the time. And to help us with that, we have our captain of clocks, Miss Kelsey Cowan, who's going to be keeping an eye on the time, making sure that we are on schedule. And she's going to take a minute here and just explain to you all exactly how you tell time. Kelsey?
That's right. We're counting down to noon, and I'm going to help you out. Now, there's two ways to tell time. One is going to be digitally. And we have digital clocks. You might find them on your computer, on your parents' phones, on your microwave, or in your car. But there's also such a thing called an analog clock. And you kind of have to learn how to read it. Here is one right here. It's usually in a circle shape, and you have all 12 hours on this clock. Now, there's also going to be two hands. One's going to be a short hand, and one's going to be a long hand. Now, the shorthand is going to represent the hour. So where the hour is pointed, that means that's what hour it is. And then the longhand is going to represent the minutes. And it goes in increments of 5. So if you actually see the longhand pointed to 3, it's going to go 5, 10, 15. It's going to represent 15 minutes, while the 6 is going to represent 30, and the 9, 45. But we actually made a huge clock here at the museum. It's nothing special by any means, but something that you guys can recreate at home. We just did ours with tape. And I was actually thinking maybe we can actually try to tell time in a really cool way, especially as we're counting down to noon. So I've got my hand. This is going to represent my short hand is my left hand. And then my right hand is going to be the minute hand, the long hand, because we've got this cardboard tube. So let's try to say, if we were trying to tell the time 6 o'clock, I would put my left hand towards the bottom, towards that 6 o'clock, and my right hand would go all the way up to that 12 right there, and that would represent 6 o'clock. But what if we got someone else to try this out as well? My buddy Steven's going to help us out. Come on over, Steven! Yeah, there you go. And I'm going to throw you this. Woohoo! Okay. So I'm going to give him some times, and let's see how he does. Okay, Steven, get ready to tell the time. 4:22. Oh, he got the 4. He's got the 22 as well. Fantastic. Okay, let's try again. How about, 8:50. Nice. Nice. He did it again. One more time. Here we go. Let's count down. When's it going to be? 12 o'clock. Nice! He crushed it! Well, guys, we might check back on this clock to see what time it's going to be throughout this program. Oh, fantastic. We'll see you soon. Back to you, Sean and Jackie.
Well, thank you very much for that, Kelsey, and thank you for helping us stay on time. We will check back with you later on in the program, but right now, I'm so excited. We have some very special correspondents for a segment that we like to call Opossum Watch 2020. We're going to go down to our animal room where Maple and Molly, the museum's two opossums, are going to share with us a little bit of the gossip and the going-ons down in the animal room. Go on, ladies. What's going on downstairs?
Hardest workers in the museum.
Yes, that must be why they're so tired. Thank you for that, Maple and Molasses. We will try to check back with you later.
You said there were going to be explosions.
As a matter of fact, I did, Miss Jackie. So we're going to check back in with our correspondent of Clocks, Miss Kelsey Cowan. But she has for us, I understand, an explosive presentation, a little fiery demonstration. Kelsey, take it away.
Thanks, Sean. Well, you know, being near the end of the holiday season, one of my favorite things has been the Macy's Day Parade. You know, all of those floating balloons going all around New York City. How awesome is that? Well, here at the Museum of Discovery, we actually made our own miniature parade. Come look over here. Take a look. We have spectators. We have balloons. Oh, look, we've got the Elsa balloon right here. Fantastic. That's a popular one. We've got a lovely seal. Oh, as you can see, I don't know if you can tell. And then just a circle, the letter O, if I do say so myself. But I want to see what we can kind of put a science spin on it, because we did not fill these balloons up with helium like you normally would to make them go up in the air. No, we filled it up with something called hydrogen, the lightest element on the periodic table. Now, there's something special about hydrogen, a reason why we put it in here. And I will say it's a little more dangerous. So that being said, we're going to see what happens when we put a little bit of a flame near those hydrogen balloons. But don't you worry, I am practicing fire safety. I am going to have on some safety glasses. There we go, good to go. And I have a fire extinguisher right nearby. Okay, so let's see what happens. I'm going to turn it on. Oh, no. Whoa, that was amazing! Okay, now, the thing that we noticed there was hydrogen is extremely flammable, meaning it can catch fire very easily. Now, I'm guessing that the Macy's Day Parade should not have hydrogen in their balloon, so we'll leave the parades up to them next year. Back to you, Sean and Jackie.
What a fantastic demonstration. Thank you so much for that, Kelsey. What did you think, Jackie? I loved it. Two thumbs up from Miss Jackie. That was fantastic. Well, up next, we've got Keisha, who's going to show us a fun do-it-yourself project that you guys can do at home.
Hi, guys. Welcome to my studio. My name is Keisha, and today I am going to be showing you how to make party hats.
So, to make our first party hat, you are going to need paper, scissors, a stapler, and some string.
So, what we're going to be doing is cutting a circle. You may want to draw out the circle before you start to cut it. It doesn't have to be perfect, but, you know, you want it to look like a circle, and sometimes that takes a little bit of practice. So, we have our circle. Next, we're going to be cutting a small triangle to the center of the circle. You may want to make a little dot to try to find your center. That's about my center, as you can see. Okay, so we're cutting a little triangle, not a big triangle, it's a very skinny triangle, just like that. Now it looks like a Pac-Man. Okay, so we're going to be taking this, and basically we're just taking our circle and we're closing it up. We're just going to close it like that. So once you close it, you're going to staple it two times on each end. Okay? And after you do this, you can color it, you can get out your markers, you can write your name on it, you can put some exclamation marks because we are getting excited because it is gonna be 2021 pretty soon. So, the next step, get a piece of string that's pretty long. You just want to stretch out your arms as far as they'll go. You're gonna take that string, you're gonna put it on one end of your party hat, and you are going to staple it. Like so. You may have to get a grown-up to help you with this, but you're gonna string it through and make a double knot, because you don't want it to come off. Okay, and then you're gonna measure to the other side. You're gonna try to measure how long the string should be. And give yourself a little bit extra room, because remember, we're gonna be tying a knot. You don't wanna make it too tight. Then we're gonna staple that end and do the same thing. Gonna tie a knot. And then you cut off any extra that you have. And there you have it, your party hat. Okay, so now for one that's a little bit trickier, we are going to take any old Kroger bag, Trader Joe's, whatever grocery store you prefer. Open it wide, and then follow my steps.
Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is fold down the sides of our bag. We are gonna fold them down a few times, just a few rolls. Then we're gonna take a hole puncher, if you have one, and just punch some holes. And I'm putting pipe cleaners through my holes just to sort of jazz it up a little bit. And I like to take my fingers and wrap them around, it makes them kind of curly and a little silly. Now I'm decorating by cutting out a heart. Then I'm just gonna take some yarn, put it through the holes, and make little bows for extra design. This is just where you get creative and you just kind of do whatever you'd like to your party hat. I am drawing on mine. I like to make a border, so I'm just drawing little hearts in a border.
There you have it. Party hats. I'm sure you can do it, and I think you're gonna have so much fun using your creativity and whatever you have at home to get it done. I believe in you, and I believe it's time to party.
Well, thank you, Keisha. I can't wait to make one of those hats.
Me either. They look like a lot of fun.
I think so. I could do it.
You probably could. And I think that's the great thing about it is it's something you guys can do at home. Mm-hmm. But don't do it just yet, because we still have some exciting things coming up for you in the program. We're going to go down right now and check and see how preparations are coming for our big grand finale countdown. Oh, looks like they have everything in place. Thomas is there. He's got all of his protective gear on. I'm very curious now as to what it is that they're going to be doing. But we don't want to get ahead of ourselves, though, yeah. Jackie. We have to make sure that we stay on schedule. So let's take this opportunity to check in with our keeper of the countdown, Miss Kelsey Callen. Kelsey, what time is it?
The time is 11:44.
Well, thank you very much for that, Kelsey. Thank you for keeping us on track. Now, while we wait, we're going to take a look at a very fun Lego build that Thomas and Keisha worked on this week at the museum. Even got a little help from a few guests that were here that day. And while you're watching that, we're going to hear from the Museum of Discovery CEO, Mr. Kelly Bass, about how things have been here the last year at the Museum of Discovery.
Happy New Year's Eve from all of us at the Museum of Discovery. I'm Kelly Bass, and for the last 8 years, I've had the joy and the privilege to serve as the Chief Executive Officer of this fabulous science center. The entire museum team has done our best to shine a bright light on the year 2020. which has been a challenging one for everyone. But as the first Americans are vaccinated against COVID-19, and there seems to be at least a little bit of light at the end of this very long tunnel, we are hopeful for a happy and healthy 2021. After being closed for 14 weeks, from the middle of March until late June, we have made the most of the situation ever since. We had 9 successful weeks of summer camps with a smaller number of participants to ensure safety and hygiene, but with the equally fun and educational experiences our team deliver every summer. Tinkerfest this year was split into 4 exciting themed Saturdays this fall, and all these hands-on activities were facilitated outdoors. Huge fun was had by all. Our 8th annual Spark fundraiser was conducted virtually, but it was still filled with cool science, and financially, it was the most successful Spark yet. So thanks to all of our generous supporters. We are sorry we couldn't have our New Year's Eve celebration in person this year, but we hope you are enjoying the fun celebration our museum team has put together for you. Happy New Year's, and we hope to see you soon.
That was nice. Thank you, Thomas and Keisha, and our guests for all of your hard work on those Legos. Up next, you can build something yourself with another do-it-yourself craft. Brittany is going to be teaching us how to make noisemakers.
Oh, sorry, parents. Who doesn't love making some noise?
I don't know anyone.
All right, well, take it away, Brittany.
This activity will be doing our own DIY noisemakers, because after all, what's New Year's Eve without making some noise? So let's get to making. In this activity, we'll be focusing on things that you can find around your home. So go for a quick scavenger hunt and see if you can find things that make really cool noises. Try different textures or try different objects that might make cool noise when they bang together. So things like bottle caps, screws, even loose change can work. But be sure to ask for your parents' help if you think something might be a little bit dangerous, like tools or hardware, because we want to make sure that you have the safest New Year's Eve possible. Now we're going to need something that you probably have in your kitchen, a paper plate. Now typically we're going to eat off of these, but today we're going to make some noise with it. So before we put our cool materials and sounds inside of it, why don't we decorate it? Like this. You only have to decorate half of the paper plate if you want to, but if you feel like it, you can always decorate the entire plate. You can also see if you have any fun party supplies left over in your house from other events in years that aren't COVID. Now we're going to assemble our noisemaker. So flip your paper plate back over, and then you're going to start putting your noisemaker inside. I also found a random bell inside my house from Christmas. Now when you feel like you have enough materials inside your noisemaker, fold your plate in half. Now, you're going to either use tape or a stapler to secure the edges of your paper plate. You might need some adult help with this if you can't use a stapler very well. Now thanks to some movie magic, we are ready to have our noisemaker. So give a good countdown from 10 at noon or 1, 2, and if you're a big trooper, you can always do this at midnight. Count down from 10 and get that noise. Happy New Year!
Well, thank you very much. What a fun craft done again with things you can find around the house. Fantastic. Well done, Brittany. We're getting closer. We've got to be getting closer. So let's check in again with Miss Kelsey Cowan. Kelsey, what time is it?
11:49.
Thank you once again, Kelsey, for keeping us on track. We are getting closer to our big finale and countdown. But before we get there, we wanted to take this chance to send out some well wishes to you from the staff here at the Museum of Discovery. And as you'll notice, our staff comes in many different forms. All different shapes and sizes.
You know some of those are animals, right?
Absolutely.
Man, 2020 has brought discomfort to us in many different ways. I hope this video lifts you up.
Happy New Year.
I love New Year's because New Year's mean new treats. Yeah, new toys.
Happy New Year! May 2021 be our best year yet.
The thing I'm looking forward to most in the new year is sleeping.
Happy New Year!
We don't really know how to count, so every year is pretty much the same to us. But Happy New Year anyway.
Happy New Year's! And here's to a healthy and happy 2021.
Yeah, Happy New Year, whatever. Hey, got any crickets?
I want to wish you all the most happiest of New Year's.
Oh boy, I'm so happy to be part of the museum now. I can't wait to see everyone in 2021.
Happy New Year!
I hope I get bigger next year.
No, they can't see me. Oh, Happy New Year!
Happy New Year!
2020 is the year I came to terms with not having legs. So 2021, I'm just going to be working on myself.
Happy New Year!
Oh, this is the life. Happy New Year to you and your family.
I'll say what my mom always taught me. Just keep swimming. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year from our family to yours.
Hey. You think we'll get that hot tub next year? My only wish for 2020 is all the fish I can eat.
Happy New Year!
More delicious food in 2021, please. Yeah, shooting that opossum watch segment is hard work.
I don't think I've ever seen those opossums awake.
That is very true. Perhaps we should take advantage of the fact that they were just awake giving us some well wishes to do another Opossum Watch 2020. Let's check in with Maple and Molly down in the animal room. Very sorry about that, folks. Apparently, Maple and Molasses were just not able to stay awake for more than 5 minutes. But that's... Do you hear that, Jackie?
No.
It sounds like a dance alarm.
Sean?
Yeah?
You have got to lay off the caffeine. Dance.
What's a TikTok?
You wouldn't understand.
I guess you're probably right. I do have a difficult time understanding all these new technological digital things that everyone is doing. But you know what I do understand? I understand analog clocks. So let's go back and check in with Miss Kelsey Cowan, our keeper of the countdown. Kelsey, what time is it?
Eleven 55.
Oh my goodness, Jackie, it is just about time for our final countdown. So let's go over to Thomas and Stephen and see just what it is that they have in store.
In store?
Yes.
We have, let me turn it on for you, a mini vortex. Opossums.
I didn't mean
that
the
are awake.
Store. Yes, you have all of these wonderful
dinosaurs.
Things that make perfect gifts for all of your family and friends.
We have this great book, but, Animals in Art.
Let's go see what Stephen and Thomas are up to.
Gift shop.
Hey, folks. 2020, wow, what a year. We thought here at the Museum of Discovery we'd finish it with a bang. So we are going to do a giant liquid nitrogen cloud. Right here, got a big drum with a steel container inside that's going to shoot some nitrogen way up into the air, and it's going to look fantastic. We need two key ingredients for this thing. We're going to need, one, some liquid nitrogen, which I have right here, and two, we're going to need some hot water. Steven's going to go get that in our classroom right now. So what is nitrogen? Well, it is really, really cold nitrogen. Now, nitrogen is a gas that's all around us, so it's very, very common. But this stuff, it's a little different. This is cold enough that it's going to be condensed into a liquid. Take a look when I pour it out. Isn't that amazing? It's so cold that it's going to start condensing the air around it into a fog. Now we're going to put this way down into this steel container, and it's chilling the air all around us. Get the last little bit out. You can see it cooling everything off. I think we've got it all. All we have to do now is wait for Steven to bring out our hot water, and we're ready for the finale of 2020. And I'm excited for it.
We are also very excited. Are you excited, Jackie?
I'm so excited. There's got to be an explosion coming up.
I would hope so. He kind of, you know, built up to that there was going to be some big finale here. Yeah. But before we do that, it looks like they're just about ready. We really should check in one more time with our keeper of the countdown, Miss Kelsey Cowan. Is it time yet?
It's time. It's time. Woo!
Are you ready, Steven? Fans, are you ready to finish this year with a bang? It's just about time for noon, so let's get that countdown with
10,
9,
8,
7,
6,
5,
4,
3,
2,
1.
Well done! Happy New Year!
That was incredible. Well, thank you all so much for joining us here for our virtual New Year's Eve celebration. We hope that you had a great time. I know I did. We can't wait to see you guys back here in the museum next year. My name is Sean.
And I'm Jackie.
Thank you so much for tuning in. We'll see you next time.